Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Thivimon Chomphukam. I'm currently studying at Mahasarakham University in Thailand. Today, I'm here to talk to you about plants leaf image recognition using multiple GITE, local descriptor and dimensionality reduction approach. To start with all this kind of introduction and contribution, then all mentioned proposed plant leaf recognition method and plant leaf dataset. After that, we'll consider experimental results, and finally, I'll summarize my presentation. Introduction: plants are living things that relate directly to humans in that they are used as a food and medicine. Botanists have collected and studied variants plant species which can be of some benefit for humans. However, while the physical characteristics of some plants are similar, they have different benefits and toxins. As such, the ability to distinguish the type of plants requires an advanced knowledge of botany. A typical plant classification problem is the diversity of plants and their botanical characteristics. Nowadays, computer vision and machine learning are used as instruments for recognition and classification. This research aims to use image processing and machine learning for plant classification by classifying plant leaf photos taken from the laboratory. Contribution: the research focuses on importance of plant leaf recognition by experiment with folio dataset. The multiple clip divide plant leaf into subregion. Then it bring to subregion to calculate the spatial features using variance feature extraction technique that pull out the distinctive characteristic of the some plant leaf. The method are histogram of oriented gradient, hop, local binary pattern, LVP, and color histogram. Finally, the feature will be fed to the dimensionality reduction method by using principal component analysis. In order to reduce the feature vector size of each method, the size reduction have direct effect on training time and increase the recognition efficiency as well. In this paper, the feature vector was used in training and recognition by support vector machine and multi-layer perceptron. This method obtained a very high recognition rate when compared to the deep learning method. Proposed plant leaf recognition method. In this figure, the input images were forwarded to the multi-gib based process to divide the images into subregion. Then a subregion was calculated by using three techniques of feature extraction. Each technique was calculated by principal component analysis method in order to decrease the amount of feature vector. Finally, researchers put all feature extraction and principal component analysis in concatenate to use it as a feature vector. These experiments, the CRISPR, were determined that six different types, including grid size of 1x1, 2x1, 4x2, 8x4, 2x2, and 4x4. After that, its subregion was calculated to find the feature vector. Feature extraction technique by using number one is histogram of oriented gradients, a method that extracts the characteristic of the image by calculating the oriented gradient from gradient image by finding gradient in horizontal and vertical, which is calculated from pixel intensity. Number two, local binary pattern, is designed for extracting characteristic of pixel points from neighborhood pixels, and color histogram. This research used two types of color models. There are RGB and HSV color models. and the feature will be fed to the dimensionality reduction method. This method use PCA in feature vector reduction. Feature vector from each technique had been reduced to only 80 features. These techniques improve the accuracy rate as well, then forwarded to the classification process. This research used two types of classification algorithm, including support vector machine for the experiment using the research technique was used to set the base parameter, the base C and gamma parameters of the SVM with the RBF kernel and 100 and 0.1 respectively. And the multi-layer perceptron, this research used two types, hidden layer are used where the size of each layer is 512 hidden units. The dropout regularization is used to prevent neural network from overfitting. The dropout rate of 0.5 for all hidden units are selected. Plain sleep dataset. The plain sleep images used in experiment were taken in the laboratory. Thus, most images have the white background. The background makes the leaf permanent and clearly separate them from the background. The leaf data used in experiment was the Folio dataset. The data represents 32 species of leaf pen images in this figure. All images were saved in the JPEG format and contain 637 images. Some plant leaves are shown twice. They are the same type, but they have different shapes. For example, papaya, chrysanthemum, and kitambilla. Image differentiation of each species are shown in this figure. And some plant leaves still have similar shapes, such as star apple and pomijacos in this figure. The vector mentioned above have directly affected the accuracy of recognition. Dataset preprocessing, the process starts by converting all the images to black and white in order to find the plant leaf area. Region of interest ROI, then crop to get ROI. The next step is check the image of the leaf in horizontal position and then rotate the image to vertical shape. After that, the image resizes are resized to 400 pixels. The width of each picture will have different size because some plant leaves are slender. Finally, when ROI was identified and resized, the color image for feature extraction process was used. Experimental results. In this experiment, we used five-fold color validation to evaluate the result of the plant leaf recognition methods. We used a training set of 80%. The result in the indeed table show, we can see 15 different results here. The Hochbau method obtained a worse performance compared to the other feature extraction techniques. On the other hand, the current histogram LBP Hoch PCA when combined with the SVM with the RBF kernel algorithm significantly outperform the other techniques and provides a high accuracy of 99.06%. Subsequently, the plant leaf recognition obtained a high accuracy of 98.75% when combined the color histogram, LBP, Hoch, PCA, and MLP algorithm. We also compare our proposed method with a fine-tuned deep convolution neural network on research of Pavala with R, ArrayNet, and GoogleNet architectures. Furthermore, the data augmentation techniques consisting of contrast and illumination technique were compared as well. The accuracy result between our proposed method and fine-tuned deep CNN are shown in this table. The performance of our proposed list 99%. Our proposed method performed better than the deep CNN architecture. However, the fine-tuned deep CNN with the combined data augmentation technique slightly outperformed our proposed method. This is because the fine-tuned deep CNN were trained from millions of images, and the training data increased 4,000 images from the data augmentation technique. Our proposed method train and create the plant leaf recognition model from only 510 plant leaf images. Conclusion: in this paper, we conclude that the performance of multiple GIP and dimensionality reduction-based descriptors visit our proposed method is much better than the histogram of oriented gradient combined with back-of-work techniques, our fine-tuned deep CNN architecture, with our ArrayNet and GoogleNet architecture as well, and increase the accuracy performance and decrease the number of the feature vector of the branch leaf recognition system. In future work, we would like to study the effect of parallel CNN architecture and use this architecture to train the branch leaf images. Thank you for your attention.